Let us discuss another important term in this section, that is current density. You must understand current density because this is a parameter which relates the electric field established by a battery in a conductor and its current. So, this relationship is quite useful. The very first thing we must know is current density is a vector in the direction of current flow. Always remember that current is a scalar quantity which only gives us the rate of flow of charge and magnitude. But current density is a vector in the direction of current flow which gives us the actual direction where the current is flowing or it has to flow in a given region. And we can also write it is denoted generally by the letter J. Another important fact about current density, we can write about its magnitude as it is the current flowing per unit cross-sectional area of a conductor. This is the magnitude of current density. So, if we talk about a given cylindrical conducting wire, which is having its cross-sectional area S, you can write say its area is S. Now, in this situation, if current is flowing, a current I is flowing in this direction, then we can say current density J vector exists in the direction of current. And this J vector we can write as I by S multiplied by S cap, where S cap is the unit vector in the direction of area vector from which the current is flowing. This is the way how we define. And sometime we are given with the area which is not cross-sectional like this. Say if this is a conductor, if we consider an inclined area in the section of this conductor and say its area is S. In this situation, if it is inclined at an angle theta to the direction normal to the current flow, or it is at an angle theta to the direction of normal cross section, in this situation the normal cross sectional area we can write as S cos theta. If S is the inclined area, normal cross-sectional area will be S cos theta, and if a current I is flowing in the conductor here, current density in this situation we can write as J, which is I by S cos theta in magnitude. Vectorially you can multiply the direction along the current. It will not be the direction along S unit vector of area S. So, here current can be written as Js cos theta, which vectorially can be represented as J dot S. So, J dot S can be written as the total current flowing through the conductor if J is the current density and S is the area through which we are calculating the current. Here you can see the total current which is passing through S cos theta is same which is passing through the area S. So, it won't make any difference whichever area we take. But for calculation of current density, we need to consider normal area only, which will be the projection of the given area in the direction normal to the flow of current.